My bad. I'll edit this part out. Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Time Travelers Book Club. I'm Taylor, here with my friend Kim.
Hello.
And this month was our time travel book. So we read Oona Out of Order by Margarita Montimore, which is such a cool name, by the way.
Yes.
It's a very main character name.
No.
And so this book is about Oona, who on her 19th birthday, which is also New Year's Eve, she suddenly at midnight transports from 1983 to 2015. And as we read the book, we realize that every year at midnight on her birthday, she is going to be transported to another, not maybe linear point of her life. So we kind of just follow her as she picks up on different parts of her life throughout various decades. So what'd you think?
I really liked it. I liked a lot of things. I love that. It was just fun to kind of go back through like whenever she jumped, you know, the 90s, and then they do like all the things that are happening in the 90s mm-hmm. when she was hanging out in New York. And I loved her mom. Her mom was there. Her mom was there. Every time she woke up on New Year's, her mom knew about it somehow magically and was able to kind of reacquaint her to whatever year she was in. And she left herself a letter every year. Like at the end of each year, there was like, here's what's going to happen this year, kind of. Yeah.
Here's how you can prepare yourself.
Or completely mess up your whole entire year if you want.
There were some warnings included in the letters that she very much chose to ignore. So.
Right. Yeah. But I mean, I don't know. I feel like I might have done the same thing.
Yeah, oh, absolutely. I would have been like, I'm making my own choices.
I like how she was like, at one point, I can't remember which year it was, but she was kind of like, you know what? I know I'm not going to die because I've seen myself in the future. So I'm just going to go ahead and live completely recklessly.
That was her club kit phase in the early 90s, which was
so fun to read. It was.
And I think a lot of the things that I think lack in our other time travel novels are like pop culture references.
Yeah.
And this book was chock full of them, which I really loved.
Yeah, that was fun.
There was all kinds of like, she was really into music. She was in a band in the 80s before this started happening to her. Mm-hmm. Her band was going to go on tour. So she really connected with a lot of musical people throughout the book and talked about like when she jumped to 2015, she had guitars from like Jimi Hendrix. She had Bowie's guitar. She had a bunch of.
I know.
Really, yeah.
I wanted to go hang out in that room that she had with all her records and all of her music.
And I loved that she made herself this fortress of this New York brownstone.
Yes.
And she always knew that's where she could come back to. I thought that was super smart.
I love that she broke the, you know, the time travel rule where you're not supposed to like go back and make money off of things that you know are going to happen because she totally played the stock market. I mean, that, good for her because, I mean, if you have to go through all this, you should definitely get to live comfortably. She was buying the Apple stock and knowing when it split. Yeah. I thought that was really cool. It was just a cool, you know.
Yeah. I don't know anything about stocks, so I didn't know what any of it meant, but I thought she was a genius.
Yes, her really portfolio cool. was amazing.
And I love how she called it the binder and it just labeled what happened and would happen. And she put it in a safe, even though it's just a binder, like nobody knows what it means.
No, right? If somebody from like 1997 opened it up and they're like, what the heck is Apple stock? Like, what am I going to do with that? And Google, what is Google?
Yeah.
It was funny when she jumped forward and she had all like the new technology, you know, the iPod that she had no idea what to do with all of her digital music collection. And then when she goes back to like the 90s, she's like, wait, I don't like, you know, I don't have this stuff. And like some of the times she would like reference it and people are like, what are you talking about? I think it was just really well written in a way that it was so easy to follow. Mm-hmm. And it was like the way she wrote it was so descriptive. Like you could be there. I like
that. Yeah, I really loved that because she got to go to the future and then back to the past so often, she was able to learn from things that had already happened and apply them to the past, like with Kenzie and stuff like that, her assistant.
Yes, I know. That was a good twist too.
Yeah.
Although I thought it was hard when she was with, you know, her husband that things were weird and then she had to go back to when she first met that husband. Like I would definitely have done that.
Yeah, and I loved how she tried to avoid him.
Yes.
She was like, I'm just going to get on. I know we're going to get divorced. So I'm just going to avoid even meeting him. And then he's sitting right next to her on the plane. Yeah,
that was funny.
Yeah.
It was a good book. It was an easy read. It was quick. It was entertaining.
Yeah. I read this book in like a day. I was just reading it. It was very easy to kind of page through it. I think because of all the pop culture references and things like that.
And they had all the emotions. I laughed and cried, you know.
I loved how at the beginning of each chapter, let me find one, it's separated into parts, the different years of travel that she went to. Hold on, let me find one. And it told the age she was, it said the year she was in,
yes.
And it said the age she was physically, and then the age she was mentally.
So open my book to the same page as you.
Yes. I just thought that was really cool because it put it in perspective. Like, even if she was living in 2015, it was like her 51-year-old body, she was still only mentally 19 years old.
Yeah.
Like, it reminded me of that scene in Freaky Friday with Lindsay Lohan when Jamie Lee Curtis goes, I'm so old.
It was like 13 going on 30 too. Yeah. It was a good book.
Yeah.
I would definitely recommend it to people to read.
It was super fun. And I did feel like we were traveling through time, you know?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Sometimes I'm like, well, I didn't really feel it, but this time I definitely felt it. And it was nice that it wasn't as science-y. Like there's no like why to why this happens. It just happens. And she's like, all right, I got to deal with it.
Let's just do this. Uh-huh. I agree. It was, no science-y, like some weird spider bitter or, she got trapped in some orbit around something. Mm-hmm. It was just easy to read.
Yeah. And I always wondered if subconsciously she could kind of decide which way she was going to go, because like she starts her journey being at that party, the New Year's party that her boyfriend's throwing. And 5 minutes before she switches to 2015, she's like, I wish I didn't have to make this big decision, because she's between going on tour with her band and going to London for this job or whatever. And so I'm like, does she will this to happen? And then right after 2004, which is when she got divorced from her husband, she was like, I just want to go to the past before this. Like, I don't want to have to deal with the aftermath of this. And then she immediately goes to the year before where she meets him.
How can I do that if I don't want to make a big decision? Can I just like skip around?
It'd be real easy to make money. And I love how she kind of plays, we talked about the stock market, but she also like, she wants to keep under the radar with the amount of money she has. So she like donates to charities and stuff, but not enough to put her on any like list or anything.
Sometimes buys stock she knows is going to tank because she doesn't want anybody to be like, how are you doing that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So
I feel like they did a really good job of like keeping it. Like there was no like, well, wait a second. Well, how does that just work? You know, like they did a good job of explaining how she stayed, you know, because normally you make that money in the stock, much money in the stock market, some red flags are going to go up.
I'm going to notice. Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. They didn't like make it so fake that it was like, well, this is just unbelievable. I mean, you know, obviously it is actually unbelievable, but they did a good job of keeping it.
It made me think of like parallel universes and how like time doesn't necessarily have to be linear. This book made me a little bit existential, and I was like, what? So like, it's so weird because she gets like in an argument with her mom at one point and she's like, why did I do this? Like, why didn't future me prepare me? And her mom's like, it hasn't happened yet for me. I don't know. Like, and so it's interesting to see how she interacts with people who know, but aren't going through it.
Yeah. I really liked her relationship with her mom.
Me too. And I love how like she finds out in 2015, her first jump, that she and her mom have like a nicer relationship than they used to. And you find out that it's because she cultivated this relationship like the moment after it happened, if you're looking at it in a linear point of view.
Yeah.
So
I guess my only confusion was like, what happens to her when she jumps? Like, does part of her, you know what I mean? Like, that was my only, like, what happens after that? And like, how does she know what letter to write kind of thing? But I don't know.
And for the first few jumps, like 2015, I don't think she left a letter for herself. And like 1991, I don't think she left a letter for herself. So it's definitely weird to think that Oonas that we haven't seen yet.
Yeah. Like, well, where are those Oonas? What are they doing?
Yeah, what are they up to? Like, I wanna know all of them. I also really loved the cover of this book.
I did too. I love Oona's name also, by the way. Like, what a cool name.
I know. And I loved how like each slice of Oona is like old, young, old, young.
I didn't even notice that. So you just said that.
Yeah.
About that. Yeah.
So I thought that was neat. I also really liked when she starts taking guitar lessons with Paul. I thought that was really cute. And then towards the end, we see him again. And
I know, I love that.
I know, that really gave me a heartwarming feeling.
I feel like the end of the book, I mean, not that the beginning of the book was, it was more like disconnected, distant. And then yeah, like, those last few chapters were just like, oh, you know.
It was like a warm hug.
Yeah, it was. And it just, you could just, I was very emotional in the last few chapters.
I almost cried a couple of times, especially when she went back to 1983 and she was back at the party.
And they were all like, what are you doing? Are you drunk? And she was all like crazy talking about all this random stuff.
Uh-huh.
And she's like, oh, by the way, you know, guitar lessons and all that fun stuff.
Yeah. I like how kind of more sure of herself she began every year that passed. So that was cool. And also it seemed like her jumps got easier on her. Mm-hmm. Like she like jolted awake in a panic in 2015. And then by the, you know, 80s years, she kind of just eased herself into it.
Yeah, I think she embraced it more. And she's like, all right, let's do this.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah.
Very good choice.
This one
was a winner.
Yeah, I would definitely recommend this book too. And I feel like it could fit into a bunch of different like types of reading. It's kind of got like a mysterious aspect of what's going to happen next to it.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Also very like good, I feel like, for people who like domestic fiction and stuff like that. And even thrillers a little bit. There's some parts where like when she yells at that man outside of the club. And
that was a terrible idea.
I know, but that was in her I can't die face.
Yeah, uh-huh. I'm gonna try real hard, but
I know. It also made me think about like free will and like, is everything laid out for us? Is there a plan?
Yeah. And you know what was interesting about like that particular chapter was like, you go back and you think about like in that time, you know, because she had her friends that were like a drag queen and like that wasn't okay, and you know, it's like, it's hard to grasp that.
And it's,
I know it's a lot of places it's probably still not okay, but
yeah,
I don't know, like in her mind, like that was just such a normal thing. And
mm-hmm. you know, to, yeah, 2015 when she yeah. it was
mm-hmm.
I don't know, I wish we could have seen some of those earlier characters again, especially yeah. since
I wanted her to meet her friends up again, like especially that group. Those, they seemed like a lot of fun.
They seemed like a lot of fun. And she did give like investment advice.
We need a side story about that person.
Oh, I want to know.
I want to know
your book all from like Kenzie's point of view,
right?
And from her mom's point of view, like
yes,
be a total series, and I'd be so
yes. I'm down. Who are you? We need you to write more of these, please.
I know. I absolutely told myself that she's writing another book now that's supposed to come out soon in 2022, I think. And I'm like, oh, I'm definitely going to read that book because I really liked the style that this was written.
Yes, I agree. It was really easy to read mm-hmm. and really did take you to the places yeah. without being like overly, like, I don't feel like there was any parts of it where it's like, all right, this is too much information. You could have shortened mm-hmm. this up to like way shorter, but no, I think everything that was in there was intentional and helped the story.
And I think this could go for like a bunch of age ranges, because people who, you know, I wasn't alive in 1982, however, a bunch of people were. And I think they would love the like nostalgia that comes from that. And even the earlier stuff that she mentioned, as well as stuff right up to, I think the last year that we see her in, or the most recent year for us, is 2017.
Yeah.
There's something for everyone. Yeah.
Winner, winner, winner.
So obviously Kim and I both enjoyed this book. If you want to check it out, we have it in so many formats. I also forgot to mention, Amazon did option to make this a series, so that'll be fun. It was announced earlier this year, maybe in March or April. I haven't seen anything about it since. However, we're in a pandemic, so.
Definitely that.
But yeah, if you want to read this, we have it on audiobook, we have it in large print, we have it in ebook, we have it in regular hardcover, and so you can get it anywhere. Absolutely. Oh, I couldn't hear you.
I said we suggest that you do.
Yeah, I definitely suggest that you do. It was very time travel without like the overly technical aspects, which was good. So yeah. So the next book we're going to do is another historical fiction, if you will. It's called The Silent Companions by Laura Purcell. And you can catch that here on Facebook or on YouTube on October 19th. And we'll see you then. It should be a good one, I hope. All right, bye.
Bye.